Hello everyone, I am Odious Orbit with Odious Kangaroo. So in this video, we're gonna go over basic gameplay mechanics and the best way to play with your teammates.
Blackout Protocol is a twin stick shooter, so you can actually play with your mouse and keyboard, or you can also play on controller. I personally play on mouse and keyboard. Your right click will provide aim sight down, which Orbit is showing over there. For weapons that have charge ups, you can actually charge up using your right click as well. And then once it's fully charged up, you can use your left click to fire. And this game is best played with three people. So try to get a full team together and come along. Another mechanic that you can use is a space bar on the keyboard, which is dodging. So you actually get to roll with the dodge, but there is a cooldown, so you can't spam your dodges.
While you're dodging mid-roll, you actually won't get hit by the enemies. You'll see that when Kangaroo rolls through it, she's not gonna take any damage. Keep that in mind when you're trying to dodge projectiles or just enemies in general. Her specialty is increasing the fire rate of her weapon. If you take a look at my demonstration, if I were to not use my ult, you'll see that this is my normal attack fire rate. But if I were to press Q, you'll see that it starts to go a lot faster.
So Beaker is actually a nice support. So I'm gonna do a little damage to Orbit here. And my special ability actually heals, but it only heals around a certain radius. So you want to make sure and communicate with your team that you are ready to heal and make sure that everyone is around you before you actually hit that Q.
Scalpel is a very unique character. Her specialty is pretty much a stab with the knife. If she were to kill with that attack, she'll actually regain HP for herself. And another nice perk of her Q is that it does psych damage when she uses it. So if I were to kill an enemy with that, I would regain health.
So Boy Scout's special ability is actually in an AoE attack. So what it does is it pushes enemies away from him and it also does damage. Great for crowd control, great for hordes of enemies, and you see that rippling effect and it'll push those enemies back to where that ripple had stopped.
Blackout Protocol is a co-op roguelike shooter. One of the most unique aspects about Blackout Protocol is that friendly fire is always active. This is not something that you can toggle off. Make sure when you're aiming down the sights of your weapon, you know, watch your angles.
So communication is key within this game. There are actually a few ways to communicate with your teammates. We do have in-game voice chat. You can turn that on, turn it off, or toggle it. And there's also quick chats. If you press C, you'll be able to see the different quick chats that we have. And there's also a ping system.
Reloading is also a very important thing in the game. You'll see with the more higher powered weapons, for example, the minigun and the flamethrower, there is a long charge time. So it's always a good idea to mention if you're charging your weapon up or even reloading. Weapons like the minigun, for example, have a really long charge time and a really long reload time. So maybe communicating to your teammate like, hey, I'm reloading my weapon, so you might want to cover my back a little bit. It's probably a good idea. Ammo is not shared within the team. If I were to pick this up, that means Kangaroo would be out of ammo or won't have access to this ammo case. So it's always a good idea to communicate to your teammate that, hey, I'm gonna grab the ammo because I'm low, or maybe ask your teammates like, hey, who needs this? For example, I have zero in both in the assault rifle, so it might be a good idea for me to pick this up because it's possible that ODS Kangaroo is actually full when it comes to her primary weapon.
I have good enough ammo so you can take it.
Yeah. So I'll go ahead and pick that up.
Make sure you're using all of these communication tools just because communicating with your team will make or break your run.
As you can see right there, I just died.
Oh. Yeah, because he wasn't communicating with me, so he died.
So that should do it for video 1 regarding basic gameplay and other tips for teamwork. In video 2, we'll be covering the safety area. Hopefully you'll catch that one real soon. I'll see you later.